Hello everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayashree this side. I'm sharing with you all today how to create a cute love banner, or as many call it, a bunting. But before we dive into the tutorial, please do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest videos. I will be using Be Mine collection for this project. I have selected 4 designs for this banner. I am now going to cut them to size 2.5 inch using mini trimmer from Dress My Craft. I'm also cutting another piece of the size 3 inches. Now using the banner punch, I am first punching the 2.5 inch strips of paper. Now, since the punch does not have the 3 inch size, I am using the complete width of the punch to insert my paper and punch the banner. Once done punching, I am going to trim off the excess from the bigger pieces of banners created using scissors and then the paper trimmer. And here our layered banner pieces are ready. Next, I am using the newly launched vintage alphabet die set and some golden glitter foam sheet to die cut out the word love. I am using here the very compact and cute Easy Cuts die cutting machine from Dress My Craft for this. The rollers of this machine are very strong and cut in just one to and fro roll. Ultimate die cleaning tool to clean and separate the alphabet cutouts from the die. Now I am distressing the edges of the banners and inking the edges using distress oxide ink in the color Victorian Velvet. Once done, I am using the Distressed Blocks Mixed Media Stencil and applying some white gold icing paste through it on the smaller banners. This will help us get the very subtle golden sheen along with the texture. Icing paste dries, I am adhering the textured banners on top of the bigger ones using 3D foam tape to add dimension. Next, I have already decided the basic composition that I want to build on my banners using the die cuts and fussy cutout elements. And now it is time to adhere everything together and form the composition. I am starting off by adding a tropical swirl die cut using liquid glue and then fussy cut out elements on top using foam tape for some dimension. I am as always adding some silk thread in golden color for more texture. And also adhering a metal charm for an added interest. Lastly, adhering the alphabet L on it. I am now going to embellish all the leftover banners in the similar way. While I am adhering all the elements in their places on the banners, why don't you give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying watching this tutorial. Also, the list of all the products used in this tutorial is given in the description box below, so do check that out. Thank you. poking holes on the top corners of the banners. Next, I am inserting the pink satin twine through the holes to hold the banners in one place and form the love bunting. For the final touches, I am adhering some heart-shaped droplets in assorted sizes randomly. Then, some set with heart sequins and lastly, some pearl micro beads. These small things add a lot of interest to any project as well as adds up to the layering of elements without having to actually layer many elements. I added some sentiments cut from the motif sheet on each banner. I hope you like this tutorial and are inspired to make one for your home as well. This bunting is very versatile and can be used at any occasion. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel before you go. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye-bye.